my recollection of us starting playing together was we had jammed one time at a friend of ours' house.
Yep.
And so we had just gotten together to jam one time. And so I called you, it couldn't have been too long after that, and said, hey man, and you were off the road at the time. You'd kind of, I think, semi-retired from road work. And I said, would you be interested in taking a gig with me? And you considered it and you thought about it and you kind of come back out of, I pulled you out of retirement, so to speak. And that's my version, or that's how my recollection of getting you to play in the band. But
that was it.
Maybe you can add something to it.
No, that's basically the way it happened. Your idea at the time was to go out and tour for a year and get some songs tight and then go into the studio and record them.
Which turned out to be Traveler.
Which turned out to be Traveler. And as far as me having to consider it, there was no consideration. It was just like, I think I told you I needed to think about it, but in my mind I was already saying, yeah, I'll do that.
Well, so, good. I'm glad you did. I think it worked out. I don't know why I told you that I didn't need you. Can't you see that, baby? I was wrong. They wanted me to talk about, you know, what I look for in a drummer, but what I look for in a drummer is what you do so well. Is there are guys who hit drums, but there are guys who are drummers that are musicians, and they're not always the same thing. You know, like, you think very musically on drums. You pay attention to lyrical hits, and even when I'm playing guitar, I always tell people, you know, when I'm playing a solo or something, you guys make me sound so much better, you and JT, because you play solos with me, and you play things. You're so mindful, and we're always so in it with each other. That's what I look for in a drummer, and mainly, you know, my favorite is you to do that with. If I had you right here, right now, I'd tell you.
In the studio, you have the luxury of changing out cymbals for every song, if you need to. You don't always need to. But what I try to do is find a blend of what we've used on records and in the studio and bring that into the live world. For example, the ride cymbal, you know, it's got to be something that will work on everything live, and it's got to cut in a live situation, whereas it may not have to cut that much in a studio, you know, because you have mics on top of it. But what I'm finding is that most of the sounds that I used on records, if they sounded good on a record, they're going to sound good live.
So it's not a big difference. You don't change out cymbals too much, really.
Not really. I mean, my tastes change, you know, and that's sort of an evolution, I think. Whereas, you know, a couple of years ago, I was using more brighter cymbal sounds, and now I've sort of gone into where I was using an Avedis Crash before, which is a brighter sounding cymbal. Now I'm using a Kerope Crash, which is slightly darker, but it blends with the other stuff that I'm using. So from studio to live, you know, it's just finding sort of an average of, you know, if I use the K-Lite Ride on say 10 songs on the last album, I'm gonna use that live,
right?
You know, and it may change during the course of touring. You know, I may find that I may want to put the Avedis Ride back up there for a little while. It's just, and that's one of the great things about Zildjian cymbals, is that they offer so many choices in terms of sound, and there's really a pretty broad palette to choose from.
Yeah, you can find whatever color you need.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. They make it, you know.
Yeah.
Some of the ones that I used on the record, going back a few records, I'm still using live. We'll be right back.
prefer a new cymbal, or do you like, is there a sweet spot for wear on a cymbal for you?
Well, with the Avedis series, they were kind of designed with the way that they made cymbals in the 60s, the A cymbals.
Yeah.
So that age and that broken in feel was there from the beginning.
Yeah.
I like cymbals that are worn in,
yeah.
You know, they're broken in.
Yeah.
And to me, the ones that I use, they only get better. Every time I hit them, I find something different that maybe wasn't there the day before.